गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 10th. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी वेल एट योर होम. एज यू नो लॉकडाउन इज गोइंग ऑन. इट मीन्स स्कूल इज गोइंग टू क्लोज फ्रॉम टूडे ऑनवर्ड्स. सो देयरफॉर वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर स्टडी थ्रू ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म. ओके, एंड आई विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म्स द एक्सरसाइज. I hope all of you will support and cooperate. Today we are going to start the topic revisiting irrational number. As in class 9th, all of you have studied about irrational. Those number which cannot written in the form of p by q are called irrational numbers. Okay. On the same time, you can also say the numbers are in decimal expansion. Non-terminating and non-repeating numbers are also called irrational numbers. Okay. Now, today we are going to prove under root 2, under root 3 or any irrational number, okay, is a irrational number. During the process to prove under root 2 is irrational number, we need to understand some points. Okay, so let us discuss. The first point we will discuss, or our first question should be, what is coprime? I know that from your side many students know about coprime, but I will discuss the meaning of this word coprime. Okay. The answer of this question is, if any two numbers having only one as a common factor, so numbers are called coprime. Okay. Example ke taur par, we can see some example. Like, suppose the factor of 2 is 1 and 2. The factor of 3 is 1 and 3. So, in both the number, you can see only 1 as a common factor. So therefore we can say 2 and 3 are coprimes. Okay. Now our next question is, theorem 1.3. I request to all of you, please open your NCERT textbook and try to understand the things which I am explaining. What is theorem 1.3? Theorem 1.3 says, let P be any prime numbers or prime number if P divide A square, then P divides A also, where A is any positive integer, okay. What is Theorem 1.3 says, if P be any prime number and P divides A square any real number, any positive integer, then P divides A also. Okay. So, we need to keep this theorem in our mind to prove under root 2 or under root 3 is irrational number. Okay. So let's start. How can we prove? we are going to see the procedure to solve our problem. So very first problem is show that under root 2 is irrational number. Okay, we all know under root 2 is irrational number, but here we will learn the writing skill for proving under root 2 is irrational number. Okay, so first of all we will consider or assume under root 2 as a rational number. So let's start proof. Suppose under root 2 is a rational number. Okay, then it will be equal to P by Q, where P and Q are co-primes. Okay, this is very important part. We need to consider P and Q are co-prime. Regarding this statement, we will arise contradiction. Okay, so let's see. Now you can transpose the variables like Q. So we can write here in next step, root 2Q is equal to P. Now squaring the both side, we will get 2Q square is equal to P square. Okay, now you can see if you will transpose 2 from left to right, then 2 divides P square. You can see here, and I hope you remember theorem 1.3. Okay, so here we can use the theorem. What is our theorem? We can write in equation 1, 2 divides P square. So 2 also divide P. Okay, I hope you understood. Now let us assume P as a some integer, like we can consider, let us assume P is equal to 2m. Okay, P is equal to 2m, and put 2m at the place of P. Now 2q square is equal to 2m whole square. Here putting the value of P in equation 1. Okay, try to understand the steps we are using to prove under root 2 is irrational number. Now if you will open the bracket, it means you will square. So 2 square is equal to 4m square, or q square is equal to 2m square. Now you can see 2 is in multiplication of m square, or can be division in q square. Okay, so here again we can write in equation 2, 2 divides q square. So 2 can divide q also, but here we had assumed P and Q are co-prime. Now we can see from above two statement, P and Q has one more factor other than 1. So here we can write from above statement, we can see P and Q have one more factor 2 other than 1. So our assumption was wrong. Okay, wrong. Our assumption was wrong, hence under root 2 is irrational. I hope all of you understood how can we solve or how can we prove under root 2 is an irrational number. Okay, so let's see another part from exercise. I'm going to erase it and you may write, no, you can pause the video and you can write all these things. Now, in your NCERT textbook, exercise 1.3, question number 1. You can see question number 1 says, exercise 1.3, question number 1. Prove that under root 5 is irrational. Same procedure we will follow to show. Okay, so let's see. I know now all of you are aware how can we write and how can we prove it. Okay, so let's see. In solution, abbreviate form. So let under root 5 is irrational P by Q, where P and Q are coprime. This is very important part. You must write this information in your solution. Now, squaring both sides, we will get root 5 Q whole square is equal to P square. Then 5q square is equal to p square. Now you can consider this equation or this function has a equation 1. Here you can write or you can use theorem 1.3. In equation 1, 5 divides p square. So 5 can divide P also. Okay. Let us assume P is some another integer like 5R. Okay, 5R. You can consider any variable. This is your choice. And putting in equation 1. Now 5q square is equal to 5r whole square, or 5q square is equal to 25r whole square, or you may also write q square is equal to 5r square. It means 25 can be divided by 5, okay, or can be divisible by 5. Now same statement written for q also. Here we can write in equation 2, 5 divides q square. So 5 divides q also. And both the statements are very important. Through these both statements, our assumption become wrong. Okay. So here we can write, therefore P and Q R or Q having one more factor as 5 other than 1. Okay, so in this case we can write, so our assumption was wrong. So this contradict under root 5 is irrational number. I hope all of you now understood all these things. Okay, try to do the rest part of this exercise and send to your respective subject teacher. Okay, so thank you, bachcho.